Hey there, I'm Sanketa and welcome to SK Productions Video Editing Series. In this lesson, we will talk about how to create a sequence and proper sequence settings for Full HD video, UHD and True 4K videos. We will also talk about the video dimensions for vertical video, square video and full portrait videos, which are commonly used for social media platforms like Instagram, YouTube, Facebook and LinkedIn. In our first lesson, we talked about the interface and layout of the Premiere Pro. We also talked about how to import the media files into the project. If you haven't watched that video, then I would recommend watching that video first. You can click on this link to watch that video. Now let's start our lesson number 2. We will create a sequence, but before creating sequence, first we will create a new folder or bin where we can put that sequence because we want everything organized, right? Then let's go back to our main folder. To go back, click on this icon. Here we will create a new folder or bin. Click on this icon. It says new bin. I will give it a name sequences. Double click on it. And here we will create a new sequence. Suppose you are not sure which settings you want, or you want the same camera settings on which you shot your footage, then you can actually just grab the footage and put it on the timeline and it will create a new sequence with camera settings. Let me show you how it works. So let's go back to our footage folder. When you double click on the media file, it opens in source monitor. You can play it to see your footage or you can just scrub through it. Let's suppose you want to use this footage. Click on it and simply drag and drop it on the timeline. And you see, new sequence is created with the same name as the media file. You'll see this new icon. It's a sequence icon. So if you see this icon, that means it's a media file. And if you see this icon, it means it's a sequence. Let's check its sequence settings. Right click on the sequence and click on sequence settings. And here you will get all the information about that sequence. Frame rate is 2997 frames per second. It's not highlighted, but the frame size is 1280 by 720. And aspect ratio is 16 by 9. Audio sample rate is 48,000. Click on cancel. This is a quick way to create a sequence with the camera settings. Now let's create a new sequence with the settings which are commonly used for full HD videos. To create a sequence, click on this icon. It says new item and click on sequence. This window will open. Click on the settings. Editing mode, select the custom. For time base, we will set to 23976 frames per second. This frame rate is usually used in film or you can use it for your YouTube videos. It gives a kind of cinematic look. But you can use 2997 or 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second. Use it according to your project. Set frame size to 1920 by 1080 and aspect ratio to 16 by 9. Pixel aspect ratio set to square pixels. Display format set to 23976 frames per second. And for audio sample rate, set to 48,000. And make sure that in video previews, preview file format is selected to iframe only MPEG. Now let's save this setting so that whenever you want to create full HD video, you don't have to fill it up again. So we will save it as a new preset. Click on Save Preset. I will name it Full HD 1080p 23976. You can write any description you want. Hit OK. And it will appear here under Sequence Presets, Custom. Now we will give a sequencer name. I will call it Full HD Video. Hit OK. Nowadays, many people use 4K Ultra HD videos or True 4K videos. The frame size is different for those videos. So for 4K Ultra HD video, commonly known as UHD video, frame size is 3840 by 2160. And for true 4K video, frame size is 4960 by 2160. It's a little wider than UHD video. Now let's create preset for those videos. Click on new item. Click on sequence. In settings, we will keep editing mode custom. We will keep the frame rate 23976. We will change frame size to 3840 by 2160. And in video previews, you can keep the video frame to 1920 by 1080. It will help to play video smoothly on your timeline. Now click on Save Preset. I will give it a name UHD 23976. You can write any description if you want. Then hit OK. And you can see your preset here. Now we will give the sequence a name. I will call it UHD video. Hit OK. Same for the true 4K video. Let's create a new sequence. In settings, we will just change frame size to 4096 by 2160. We will keep everything else same. Now, let's save it as a preset. Click on Save Preset. I will give it a name True 4K Video. Hit OK. And here you can see all your custom presets. So now every time if you want to create Full HD video or true 4K video or UHD video, then just select the preset accordingly and give sequence a name and hit OK and you will be all good. Now let's give our 4K video sequence a name. I will call it true 4K video. Hit OK. We have all of our sequences here. For now, let's close the UHD video or true 4K video sequences. To close them, first select that sequence. Then click on these lines and click on Close Panel. Now let's quickly add video clip to our sequence. Then we will talk about the different frame sizes and video dimensions which are very popular on social media platform. I will add this clip to the timeline. This window will pop up. It will ask you whether you want to keep existing settings or you want to change sequence settings. Because the clip settings are different from our sequence settings. Click on Keep Existing Settings. Now we will talk about the different frame sizes or video dimensions that are commonly used on social media platforms. 1920 by 1080, aspect ratio 16 by 9, known as horizontal or landscape format. You can use it for YouTube, Twitter or Facebook. 1080 by 1080, aspect ratio 1 by 1, known as square format. You can use it for Facebook feed, Instagram feed, Twitter or LinkedIn. 1080 by 1350, aspect ratio 4 by 5, known as vertical or portrait format. It's commonly used for Instagram feed. 1080 by 1920, aspect ratio 9 by 16, known as full vertical or full portrait format. It's commonly used for Instagram story, Facebook story, etc. Now let's quickly create the presets for them. Click on new item, click on sequence. And in settings, we will just change frame size. Let's make a square format first. Put frame size 1080 by 1080. It will show 1 by 1 aspect ratio. We won't change anything else. Click on Save Preset. I will give it a name, square format 1 by 1. Hit OK. I will also give the same name for sequence. Square format. Hit OK. We will do the same for vertical video and full portrait video. Follow the same steps. Now we have all our format sequences ready. We will take a quick look at how the footage will look like in those formats. Grab the footage and put it on the timeline. Click on Keep Existing Settings. So in square format, our footage will look like this. Let's try the vertical format. Click on Keep Existing Settings. You see this black bar here? To cover that, we will need to increase the scale of the video clip. In order to do that, first select the clip and then go to Effect Controls and increase the scale till you cover that black screen. Video will look like this. Now let's try the full portrait. For this, you can increase the scale of the video to cover the black screen, or you can add text up here or down here. For now, let's increase the scale and see how it looks. Go to Effect Controls and increase the scale till you cover the black screen. You can also change its position. Your video will look like this. And in different format, your video will look like this. That's it for now. In the next lesson, we will discuss more about the timeline and we will do some editing. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, then please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And please feel free to share your comments below. I have more video editing tutorials on my channel that you can follow. Bye for now. See you next time.